Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate how to develop a REST API using IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12. You can now create a REST API using OpenAPI version 2 and OpenAPI version 3 documents in IBM App Connect Enterprise. You can either create a REST API from scratch, or you can create it using an existing OpenAPI document. I'm going to create a REST API using the de facto Petstore Open API version 3 example. I'll download the OpenAPI document and then create a REST API project from it. I can view or edit the OpenAPI document using the new OpenAPI editor that is available in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12. I will implement an operation by creating a subflow for it. After deploying the REST API to an integration server, I will view it using the web UI. I can test the REST API operation using the try it capability to check that the request can be processed by the subflow and the response is returned. So first of all, I'm going to download the Petstore OpenAPI JSON document. So this is the de facto OpenAPI version 3 example that's available. There's a version 3 OpenAPI JSON document, which I'm going to save. And now I'm going to create a REST API using the OpenAPI document. So I can click on New REST API. I can give a name for my REST API project. I'll call it Petstore, and I'll select the option to use a OpenAPI document. So I've downloaded it, so I'll select it from the file system. And now when I click next in the wizard, I can see the available operations that are defined in the OpenAPI document. I can see the resources and I can see the methods on those resources. So the REST API project has been created. I can see the REST API operations that are available, and I have a link to open the OpenAPI document using an OpenAPI editor at the top of this REST API description. So if I click on that link, the OpenAPI editor is opened, and I can use this editor to view the different parts of the OpenAPI document. I can see the different paths and the resources and the methods on those resources. So in this example, I'm going to implement one of these operations. And for this example, I'm going to implement the get method so that a user can find a pet by specifying the pet's ID. So the get method requires a path parameter, which is the pet ID, which is specified here. And it also has these responses, 200, 400, and 404. And it also has a security requirement, whereby it requires an API key or a Petstore auth. I can see what the schema should be returned for the response. So for example, if I click on 200 and then application JSON, I can see that it returns this schema, which is of type pet. And pet has these properties. So in order to implement this operation, I'm going to click on this button, which says create subflow. And now I'm returned back into the main toolkit editor, and the flow editor is opened so that I can create the subflow for the operation to get a pet by ID. So the operation requires a API key, and I have already created a common module in a subflow which validates an API key that is provided by a user. It's implemented using some ESQL in a subflow, and in this ESQL it checks that the API key should be matching the text valid 1234. And if it does not match it, then the HTTP status code 401 is returned. So I'm going to use this common module in my subflow operation. So I can do that by simply dragging and dropping the subflow onto the editor. And now I'm going to use a mapping node to map the input message tree to the output. So I'm going to set the ID that is provided in the input message tree and set it in the output. So if I open up the transformation drawer, I can drag and drop the mapping node. And I can double click on the mapping node. And in this wizard, you have an option to use the REST API operation so that it will recognize the inputs and outputs for that operation. And now I can see that it expects the output to be using the message type pet from the schema that is inside the Open API document. And I am going to take the pet ID that was passed in the path parameter and use set that in the output. So to do that, I'm going to click on task. And now after clicking on task, I'm going to scroll down to where it says REST input. And under input, I can see that it has a parameter section, and under parameters, there's a pet ID. I'm going to select pet ID. So this is the path parameter that is passed in. And I'm going to select quick link to output. So I'm going to map this to the JSON message body to the ID field. So I can see that it has added a move now, and there are a couple of fixes I need to do to set the cardinality and user convert. So I can select these links here to perform the fixes. And now that I've done that, I can see that it has done the convert. And I'm simply going to set the name of the pet in this example. Normally, I would do a database lookup based on this pet ID that's applied and retrieve a name from a database. But in this example, I'm simply going to assign a value. And I'm going to assign the value Lassie as the name of the pet. So my map has been done. I now just need to wire the nodes together. So I'll wire the input to the common module that I added. I only want to link the common module to the mapping in the case where we had a successful outcome where the API key was valid, and wire the mapping node to the output node here. In the case where the API key was invalid, I want to wire the invalid terminal, output terminal, to the output node here. So this is just an example of how you could implement the operation. There are many other ways in which you could check the API key. So now I'm going to create a local integration server. So the integration server has been started. Now, the work directory for the test server is available here in the application development view. And in order to use the trite capability from the web UI, I need to configure the test server so that the HTTP listener is enabled for calls. So to do that, I'm going to open the configuration file serverconf YAML. And I'm going to scroll down to the HTTP connector resource manager, and I am going to specify that calls should be enabled, and I will uncomment the other calls options. And in addition, the security for the operation specified that an API key was to be used in the HTTP header, so I need to specify API key as an allowed header for calls. So now that I've made those changes, I'm going to stop and start the server so that those changes can be picked up by the server on restart. And now I'm going to deploy the REST API to the integration server. I'll first deploy the shared library, which has the common module, which the REST API depends on. Now I'll deploy the REST API to the integration server. So I can see that the shared library and the REST API have both been deployed. So I'm now going to start the web user interface, and I can see the REST API, and I can see an overview of REST API, and I can see the operations. If I select the get method on the pet resource, I can select the try it capability. So first of all, I will try specifying an invalid key and specify pet ID. When I click send, I get back the 401 response saying it is an invalid API key. If I specify the correct API key and the pet ID, I get back a 200 response status code, and the response body contains the name of the pet ID. I can also use the flow exerciser to debug what request and response has been sent to the API and the response that has been returned. So if I open up the main flow using the flow editor, I can select the record button. And now if I send the same request as before, which uses the valid API key, I can click on view path and I can see the request that came in before it was sent to the subflow. So I can see that the API key was specified in the HTTP input header. So it says has the value valid 1234. And the response from the subflow contains the response body, which has the ID that's specified and the name. I can also look at the local environment if I wish and see the values that are set in the local environment. If I send the invalid value and click send, I can see the invalid value that was sent into the REST API. And I can see the status code that was sent back. So 401 was sent back, and I can see the reason code in the message body using the message assembly viewer through the flow exerciser. So in this video, I've demonstrated how to create a REST API using IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12. I created a REST API project from an existing OpenAPI version 3 document. I implemented the operation using a subflow and deployed the REST API. After deploying the REST API, I checked that the implementation was working by using the try it capability in the web UI.